know, something that I figured out that I do every day since I figured it out. Figured I'd share it on YouTube, of course. And the monkeys, I just let you know on a short video. It's gonna be like 1 minute or something. It's probably gonna be less than 1 minute, depending how long I take to show you the exercise that I learned how to do. Usually, when people get a weight that you can lift like this, but you see I'm squeezing it with my hands. You can see that, squeezing it. You know, go like this, keep your hands straight, and then go up and down. That hurts way more, trust me, because you have to put, you have to use your forearm, your upper muscle to keep that in place so it doesn't fall. Works on your chest too, because you're squeezing your chest to keep that going. It's just like, I don't know, it's like working your chest, I believe this part too, and your forearm all at the same time. I'm not entirely sure, I'm not a person that goes into detail, just figured I'd show you guys. I've been doing, it's showing me, it's giving me some good results, you know, but I've been working out for like about 3 years. I haven't even grown that much in 3 years. But most people really only do it, they're taking drugs and stuff. Another way is you put your hand behind your back, like this, and you slowly just grab it and pull it up. You know, like that. You do it with your other arm. One, two. You gotta make sure when you're doing it, you keep your back completely straight, your arm behind your back. If your arm behind your back, you're not gonna be going this as much, see? But then when you go like that, it's like you, when you don't have your arm behind your back, you're automatically used to doing it that way. So do it like this if you're used to just going like this, leaning into it. Just put your hand behind your back, get a really small weight, and get used to just lifting with your arm. Doesn't have to be heavy. Just gotta get your arm to be used to not moving your whole body when you're lifting. And then after you do those two things, like 12 times each, you go down and do some push-ups, and then after that you do some crunches. To work out your abs. I'm not gonna show my abs because honestly, like, I have no abs at all. I'm mostly just chest and arm. That's muscle right now because I've been eating a lot, trying to gain some more weight before I go back into like really jogging and exercising. Because you gotta eat a lot and work out at the same time, guys. Because if you do, you're not gonna gain no muscle at all. And that's what most people make a mistake on. Is they think they should just lose all the fat, use all their fat to put into muscle, but really they don't lose weight or gain muscle. So you gotta eat. That's a third key that nobody knows how to do. Gotta eat plenty while you work out. Or you won't see any results. Or you might see results, but not that great of results. Because if you do it that way, you're basically gonna have skaggy skin that's really saggy. Because you're not eating enough to burn the skin and calories to form into the shape that you want. So yeah, Man the Monkey signing out. If you like the video, subscribe, like the video, comment. This will be it for this tutorial. Actually, I don't know if this is called a tutorial. But I'm just showing you how to do this, I guess it is. There'll be another video of this coming up of exercise tips. I want to do some more exercising tips that I do every day. So yeah, let me know how it was.